Hello, I am Bilge Kan. Today we will discuss the potential energy and the force relations of the conservative force relations. And now we have given a potential energy function, and the question asks us find the units of k1 and k2, and then find the force vector and find the point of equilibrium state, it is stable or unstable. Now I suggest you to pause the video and solve this question by yourself, and then we can try together to solve this question, or if you solve the question, then we can discuss how you do this and how I will do this. Okay. Now I am starting. Find the units of the k1 and k2. Now this is the ux is a potential energy function, and therefore the energy units is given as hint for us. Energy units is kilogram times meter square per second square. Also, we can obtain this by F times x equals the unit of x, this is equals energy, and the unit of x is meter, and the force we can write as the force equals m times a, mass times acceleration, and the mass unit is kilogram, and the acceleration unit is meter per second square. So we can also reach it from that, but the, we are given this thing. Now we can find what is the unit of k1 and k2. Since k1x and the k2x is in the form of sum, their units should be also equals to energy's unit. Therefore, the k1's unit is also given here as nx. So this is satisfies one. This gives us 1 meter. So k1 should be meter square. Total energy is kilogram times meter square per second square. So 1 meter is here, therefore unit of k1, let's symbolize it like that, equals meter times kilogram per second square. And the k2 over x is here, so we should give an additional meter for the original energy symbolization unit system to k2. Therefore the unit of k2 equals kilogram times meter cube per second square. Now we can go on the B question. Find the force vector, it says, and now it says ux is a potential energy of a conservative force. Therefore, this potential energy caused by conservative force, and they are related as like that. Fx equals minus derivative of potential energy function of x over dx. So we know the potential energy function, and then we can take the derivative and multiply it with the negative sign, obtain the result. So taking derivative over x gives us minus sign is here, k1, also I get here k1, and now taking derivative of 1 over x gives me minus 1 over x squared, so minus k2 over x squared is here. This is our force vector. Also is in the I hat direction since it's going on x. And in the C question, find point of equilibrium state, it is stable or unstable. Now we should discuss this topic deeply. What is the meaning of equilibrium point and state? Is it stable or not, or unstable? So, for a potential energy, we can consider as two paths here. Now, equilibrium point means where the force vector of the conservative force is zero. So, we can see, for example, in a gravitational force, we can see at the top of there and at the bottom of there, top of the mountain and the bottom of the valley. We see this is the force, gravitation force vector, and this is the also ground vector. So this is N and this is mg. So we can guess mg. So we can see here the force vector at the is perpendicular to movement direction, and also the total force is zero. Now the ball in here is in an equilibrium point. Also, the ball in here is equilibrium point too. But for the understanding their equilibrium point is stable or unstable, Now, I can think like that. If I give an initial velocity for this direction, it can go there, and after that, it will go again there. So go there, so oscillating happens, and if there is a friction, this ball will end up in here again. But when I give an initial motion to this ball, so it will directly go down or directly go down here, and it will never get here again by itself. So this is the unstable meaning. Therefore, taking the second derivative of ux, d square ux over dx, this is the mathematical expression for being stable or unstable. If this is greater than zero, this means I am in here, and when I move here or to the top side, so I can get potential energy. And if I am here, then I will tend to lose potential energy. And this means I cannot get here. So this function, if greater than zero, I am in stable position, stable equilibrium. And when this derivative is less than zero, this means I am in unstable equilibrium point. So finding for the equilibrium point, as I said, fx should be equal to zero. So I find it here, fx. So this equation, in order to get this equation zero, k1 minus k2 over x squared should be equal to zero. So this means x squared equals k2 over k1, and the x is square root of k2 over k1. This is positive since it's given us x greater than zero. Now, I am taking second derivative of this function, but not the minus sign. Therefore, I can get plus k2, k2, and the derivative of x to the power minus 2 is minus 2 gets here, and this sign is blow up, and then 2k2 over x cubed I get. This is the second derivative of potential energy function. So now I see here, also I am in equilibrium point, I know the x, I am in equilibrium point square root of k2 over k1, and this is a positive number, and when I put here, it still becomes positive, and k2 is positive, so I see it's greater than zero, and so I can say this point of equilibrium, and in this point the particle is in a stable equilibrium. So thanks for watching. I hope it's beneficial for you.